Happening today, the long-awaited opening of the new Hadron Transit Hub at the World Trade Center. Chopper 2 flew over it early this morning, the indoor lights shining brightly at daybreak.
The opening comes with controversy. Here's CBS's Michelle Miller.
It's called Oculus, 15,000 tons of steel reaching more than 25 stories tall. Famed architect Santiago Calatrava designed the hub to resemble a bird rising. Its archways will house 11 subway lines, and officials estimate 250,000 commuters every day.
A democracy should be building important buildings for people. It's nice to arrive in the city in an exhilarating place that sort of gives you a lift. You know, I think those great moments are sort of like the exclamation points in the city.
As much as places like this help downtown roar back to life, it's not without its controversy. This structure is billions over budget and at least 5 years behind schedule.
When the hub's design was first unveiled in 2004, officials estimated it would cost around $2 billion. But after rush design changes, water leaks, and Superstorm Sandy in 2012, the finished product will cost almost twice as much, coming in at $3.9 billion. The Port Authority of New York and New Jersey called the project challenging, but added it will serve a vital transportation need for the region while becoming an important landmark.
It was a very, very ambitious, difficult design.
Officials are hopeful this landmark will also prove to be an economic engine. Within these public atriums is over 200,000 square feet of potential retail space.
This was a very successful mall before 9/11, and we have no doubt it's going to be a very successful shopping center.
You feel that now the life of the city has come back to this 16 acres again.
The partial opening is scheduled for 3 this afternoon. PATH riders will be able to access a new entrance at the corner of Liberty and Church Streets. The other entrances will open throughout the spring.